Hey guys, welcome back. So today I'm gonna be doing a talk through get ready with me. I'm just gonna be answering some questions in this video. I haven't done like a proper Q&A in a while and I figured I would do it as I was getting ready to film some different videos today. That is what this video is going to be on. I asked you on Twitter to ask me your questions and I've got a few to go through. So if you're interested, definitely keep watching and don't forget to subscribe before you leave. And let's just go ahead and get started. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and put our hair back. I'm actually getting my hair done this week. I'm so excited. I've had a lot of questions of people asking me if I'm gonna go brunette before the wedding, and that is a no. I really like my hair this color anyway, so I think I'm gonna keep it for a little while. Eventually, I'll probably go back dark, but we will see. It took me a long time to get to this color, so I'm keeping it for a while. I'm trying to think of like little life updates. A lot of you see a little bit more of my life on my vlog channel, so if you haven't checked that out, I will leave it below. But Davis, this is the last week that Davis is gone for a little while. I'm really excited. So I get to like see him this weekend and everything. I'm super excited about it. This is our last weekend apart for a while, hopefully. I am definitely independent. I mean, I was by myself in my house in Georgia for a long time, but I'm still adjusting to moving to a whole new state. When I first moved, it didn't hit me, I think, like for a while that I had officially moved, but it's finally hit me. I realize I am a long way from home, and yeah, I'm still adjusting. This weekend, I think we're gonna do some fun stuff, so I'm really excited. I'm gonna take the dogs with me. It's just gonna be a good time. So let's answer some of your questions. Also, I'm gonna be using the Nicol Concilio palette. I love this palette. I think it's great. So I'm gonna also be using this today. First question I see is, are you planning on wearing your hair up or down for your wedding? I am planning on wearing it down. I don't wanna do, I mean, I might do like a half up, half down. I'm not too sure. I feel more comfortable with my hair down. So that's what I'm gonna be doing. And I'm gonna have updos for the bridesmaids. So I'm going into the Nicol Concilio palette and I'm gonna be mix these two shades and I'm going to throw them into my crease. If you guys haven't checked out this palette, it's so nice. I have a July hits and misses coming up very, very soon. It might be the next video after this, but this is in there because I love it so much. I think it's so good. And Nicole's such a sweet girl. Like meeting her, she's the nicest person ever. I don't even know what look I'm going for today. I just knew I wanted something a little bit warm to kind of go with the shirt a little bit. Not too matchy-matchy. All right, maybe it will turn out a little matchy-matchy. A lot of people are asking, will I be changing my name on social media after we have our ceremony? And I'm not sure. I don't think I will. By the way, I'm going to be taking Hey Girl right now. I don't think I will just because it is like my brand name. You know what I mean? That's just what I go by, Casey Holmes. So I probably won't. Angelina asked, just asking for a second opinion, should I quit my current job that I hate and start a YouTube channel? When I started getting more views and stuff, and like I was at a job that I hated too, I didn't hate the people, I just hated the line of work that I was doing. But I did not quit right away, like without having any sort of income coming from YouTube. I feel like that's not necessarily the smartest decision in my opinion. I feel like you should have some sort of income coming in just so that you're safe and you have a safety net, you know what I mean? But I would recommend building up your channel, really making sure you can make a living off of it first and then doing it, or just finding another job that you feel like will make you feel better and then just focus a lot more into your YouTube. I mean, starting a YouTube channel is hard. I've been on here for almost 8 years now and it takes a lot of work. It's not an overnight success type of thing. I mean, for some people it is. Just take your time, and if you really love it, then do it. I always tell people don't do YouTube for the money because it doesn't necessarily last if you do it that way. I just feel like if you go into it for the money, it's not gonna satisfy you, and eventually you'll wanna give up because the hate comment. I mean, you gotta endure a lot of stuff being on the internet and just putting yourself out there, but it's worth it if you truly love what you're doing. You know what I'm saying? I would just start your YouTube channel, have it as like, you know, a hobby for a little while and work on it to make it grow. And then when you have a substantial amount to live off of with YouTube, then I would say quit your job. That's like, that might be the adult in me, but I have never like quit a job without any sort of income ever. Do you want to keep your hair short for the wedding or do you want to grow it out, use extensions? I'm growing it out currently right now. It's gotten quite a bit longer, but I will be using extensions. I'll be using my Foxy Locks extensions for some length. So yeah, I'm gonna have it long for the wedding. I'm really excited about it. But once the wedding is over, I'm chopping it off. We're going back shorter. And then I'm gonna take a little bit of pizza. Throw this in here just to blend it out. Also, you guys, I know I've mentioned this absolutely everywhere, but I have to tell my folks on my main channel, if you have not tried the cauliflower pizza from Trader Joe's, I mentioned it on my Snapchat. Oh my life-changing. It is so good. I have tried cauliflower fried rice before. It was awful. I swore I would never try anything else cauliflower again, because I was seeing everywhere that it was like the healthier option, and I was like, okay, I'll try it. Oh, I was scarred. I was scarred for months. But that cauliflower pizza, oh my gosh. It is so good. I actually show it on my vlog channel. You probably won't see it because I'm still vlogging like today and stuff, but I will feature it on there. And like I said, I showed it on my Snap, but it's so good. Okay, and now I'm gonna take this from Maybelline. I have been loving these color tattoo eye chromes. I think they're awesome. Okay, so this is in the shade Bronze Sheen, and I'm gonna go ahead and apply this on the inner part of my eye. Someone asked, are you planning on kids or any animals? If so, does the house you're at allow more animals? We can have another animal, but they have to be under, I think, like 50 pounds. At least one of the animals has to be under 50 pounds, and Daisy is like 30. So we're good. But I don't think we're gonna get any more pets. Davis really does want a baby right now. He has got baby fever. I don't think I've ever met a man who has had as much baby fever as Davis has right now. I'm personally not quite ready for kids yet. I think we need to like have the ceremony, enjoy it for a little while. Someone also said, would I ever consider having a P.O. box? And the answer is no. I just don't see myself wanting to get one because I feel like it's just going to be a lot to keep up with. I don't know. I also am not very comfortable with having a P.O. box address out there. That's just me personally. So the answer to that is no. I apologize, guys, but just don't see myself really wanting one. Right now I'm mixing Sagittarius and Glorious. I think that can be it for the eyes. I think I'm done. This is like the most satisfying part. Oh, look at that clean line. So now I'm gonna move on to face, and then I'll put lashes on and all that in a little bit, because it takes a while to do that, so I'm gonna do it off camera. But we're gonna be trying something different today. I'm gonna be trying this First Aid Beauty Triple Protection Skin Tint with Goji Berry. It has SPF 30, says it's safe for sensitive skin, and I got the shade medium. I think this is like the cutest little packaging ever. I'm thinking the medium shade will be okay for me because I just self-tanned. I did read some of the reviews, and there was someone with really oily skin that said that they loved this, so I have high hopes now. So I'm gonna take the primer water and then my Natasha Denona Anti-Shine Primer and apply these to my face. And with this First Aid Beauty thing, it didn't really say like how to apply it, so I'm just gonna apply it with a brush. I have a more dense brush I can use, and then I was thinking something like this. So we'll see. It is best. It says to shake well, like that. I'm trying to figure out how liquidy this is. It's not that bad. It looks like a regular foundation. So that's it. It's a little bit runny, but not much. And I'm gonna go in first with this Morphe G4 brush. God, I haven't used this in forever. And I'm gonna do it on one side of my face. The color is actually really nice, but I did use a shitload of product just now. Maybe this is too flimsy. So, I also have this Tarte bamboo brush that came out with, I think it was their clay stick foundation. I have this to try as well. I'm not the biggest fan of this brush, but figured I could see. The other one is definitely giving more coverage. More foundation gone. Alright, let's just try this Pure Cosmetics one. This is like an in-between, kind of flimsy, kind of more stiff. We'll see if this one's good. I'm using so much of this product though. I don't know why my neck is so much lighter than the rest of my body. As most of you know, I wear foundation or I don't. I either like it really full coverage or I just won't wear it at all. That's why I don't do too many like lighter looks, because like in my everyday life, I don't wear makeup all the time at all, which is why I don't do a lot of lighter makeup looks. Not because I don't want to, but because usually when I put on makeup, I'm just like, all right, let's go big. Let's do a smoky eye. Let's do it good. And I kind of forget about lighter looks because I want to go full in, because I love dramatic, bold looks. So when it comes to foundation, that's why I'm normally like full coverage or nothing at all. I'm interested to see how this will wear throughout the day with my oily skin. I wouldn't say it's like making my skin look perfect. I'm just gonna kind of work it in a little bit more and like
pat it in.
So I'm gonna go ahead and put that up. If you've tried this out, let me know how you like to use it. I figured I wouldn't try it with a sponge because I didn't think it would work well with it, because I thought it was gonna be really liquidy, to be honest with you. So if you have tried this with a sponge, let me know in the comments what you think. If you have any tips or tricks, I'm down to hear. So next up, I'm gonna try a new concealer. I'm so excited about this because it's the Clinique Beyond Perfecting Super Concealer, and it's in, Very Fair. Let's do one eye at a time and just see what it looks like. Now, I'm kind of confused why they came out with a Beyond Perfecting Super Concealer, because, you know, this reminds me of the Beyond Perfecting Liquid Foundation, but that can also be used as concealer as well. I don't know if you guys have tried that Beyond Perfecting Foundation and Concealer as a concealer, but it is really, really nice. I don't know if I'm obsessed. I have not had the best luck with trying out new foundations and concealers lately. I don't know what it is, but it's more of like a medium coverage concealer. It's definitely not full coverage in my opinion, because every time I use full coverage concealers, I really compare it to the Tarte Shape Tape. I don't know why I haven't been finding like amazing products lately. I love this little brush for getting right in the inner corner. It's the It Cosmetics Airbrush Blurring Concealer. I bought this a little bit ago from Ulta, and it is so good. I love it. So I'm not obsessed with the face makeup. I'm gonna go ahead and take it off because it's just not working for me. It's just breaking up here. The redness is peeking through, which throws everything off, and I'm not obsessed with the concealer, so I'm just gonna take it off. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and apply my foundation, like my regular foundation and concealer, and then I'll be back to show you guys the products that I use on my face. So I have the Tarte, no, not the Tarte. I have the Hourglass Vanish foundation on. I have the Tarte Shape Tape concealer on my lips as well. I also have the Maybelline Fit Me concealer on, and I did throw on some terracotta bronzer. Now I am going to go into this Pure Cosmetics Contour Diaries. I really like this. I like this shade right here. So I'm going to use that with this BH Cosmetics brush. Someone said, how do you like base living and have you made some close friends? It is definitely a little bit different. I'm always paranoid that I forgot my ID or something, to be honest with you. It's okay, and I've made some friends, but I haven't really hung out with too many people just because I have been traveling so much since we moved here. You know, I haven't had the time to really hang out with a bunch of different people. I mean, I've gone to like brunch and I've hung out with a couple people on the weekends, but for the most part, I've just been keeping to myself. When we first moved here, I was unpacking like a mad woman, and Davis was here as well, so we were just kind of getting the house situated, and then once he left, I started traveling more, and yeah, I just haven't had the chance to really meet a ton of people. I have met some really nice ladies. So far, I like it. I'm still adjusting, like I mentioned before. Going on a honeymoon, if so, to where? I don't think we're gonna go on a honeymoon. By the way, real quick, I'm using this No. 7 Peachy Velvet Blush. I don't know if we're gonna go on a honeymoon right after the wedding. I think at some point we will, but we haven't really planned it because I don't think we'll be able to, just due to certain things. But honestly, it's like not that big of a deal to us because we're also going on a really big trip in at the end of August that we're so excited about, and we kind of call that our pre-honeymoon, even though it's really not. It's just gonna be so much fun. But hopefully after the ceremony, we'll find some time to go on a honeymoon, and I'm not too sure where we want to go. I mean, I would love to go to Bora Bora. Gotta be realistic about it. Like, will we actually be able to go with Davis's work and everything? Any tips I've learned while wedding planning? I don't think I have any tips, but I will say I'm so glad I got a planner. Answering back to her stuff is hard enough. I couldn't imagine doing it on my own, and she's like a full service planner. That's good for me because I don't have to like interact too much with all of the companies and everything. I don't have to do all the negotiating, but she does, so that's really, really nice. It's gonna be really fun though. I'm very excited about it, so I can't wait for you guys to see everything. Some of the people that watch me, I know don't like me and don't deserve to see the wedding, but I'm doing it literally just for the people out there who love me, because I know there's a lot of you out there who love and support us. I thought long and hard about like, do I actually want to post the video online, like do I want to do that, because you know, people just have nothing better to do. And that's kind of how I felt with wedding planning as well. Like, do I still actually want to vlog it? Like, do I want to show people this process? Because some people are just nasty. There's more supportive people than there are negative, so y'all are the reason we're gonna show the video and all of that, because it's kind of like you guys are invited to the wedding. Oh my gosh, somebody asked to do a what's in my bag, and I have thought about that video so much, like doing it for my vlog channel, because I miss those videos. I miss like old school YouTube when shit was just so easy and fun. Like, I miss those days of just uploading whatever you wanted and people watched it. Like, now you have to actually, you know, come up with content that's like creative, or else people aren't gonna watch it, all this other stuff. But I'm just like, man, what's in my bag videos are honestly so fun, because I love seeing what's in other people's bags. And because I don't know, like, I'm not that nosy of a person, but it just fascinates me how some people organize their bag and like what certain things that they keep, and it makes me want to buy certain things. So I personally love them. Are you still planning on creating your own t-shirts for us to buy? I've mentioned this a while back that I really wanted to do merch or something. I think the whole process, I still do want to do it. It's just figuring out how to get started. The same with the freaking dog line. The dog line is like the hardest thing to try to come up with. I mean, I also want to own my own like online clothing boutique. If I was in Georgia right now, I would probably be pursuing that online boutique, just because I would be at home, I could purchase a warehouse, it would be a permanent location. But since Davis is in the military, you know, we have to move and stuff, and I can't commit to one area. I have three things that I want to do: come out with t-shirts, come out with a dog line, and then also an online boutique. Like, I have so many ideas for them, but I think just I'm trying to figure out how to make it work with like where I'm living and when I'm moving, and if it turned into something big, could I have someone work for me? Just like a lot in one that I'm trying to figure out. The glue is still drying on these lashes, but I did use the Lily Lashes Galichi Glam in Caviar, and I really like them. They're like completely wispy from end to end, and I really like it. Someone asked what was like a different tradition that we're gonna do at the wedding, and something that's gonna be a little bit different at our wedding is actually the cake. And I'm not gonna go into too much detail now, but it's gonna be different. It's not gonna be like your traditional white wedding cake, but I'm really excited to see it. And we're not doing a cake tasting or anything, because Davis likes vanilla, I like chocolate. I mean, if you mess that up, we have an issue. Yeah, we're doing like a different design for our wedding cake, and it's something that is more sentimental, so we are very excited about it. No! Why? Why? Oh my gosh, gotta wait for that to dry now. Someone said, what are your fitness workout tips? I just started my fitness journey and look at machines like, is it dead? So funny. When I first started working out, it was definitely a little bit harder. Now, like, I started working out like in 2013. Back then, there wasn't like a lot of Instagrammers or anything like that where you could really learn. It was just kind of like, look at the directions on the machine or ask someone. But now, I mean, there's so many different videos and just ways to learn, especially on YouTube. That's what I do. I like to go through my Instagram page and like save different videos, and then right before I go in the gym, I watch them. Sometimes I'll watch them inside the gym, and I get my ideas from there. Some days are better than others. Just test out different things, and I'm telling you, if you look, I feel like watching people on Instagram makes me more motivated, because you also get to see their techniques and like how they do certain things and how they grow the booty, and it's like your own personal trainer, but without the personal trainer. I used to always have personal trainers, especially for the last like 3 years I had personal trainers, but moving up here, I was like, okay, I'm totally gonna get one, because I hate going to new gyms and not knowing where everything is. And I actually signed up, but it took them forever to ever get back to me. Like, I think someone contacted me a week ago, and I was like, eh, I don't want to. But eventually I had just went into the gym and like started learning where everything was and where I wanted to work out. It just takes time. It really does. It just takes time, and it's definitely a learning process. You have so many videos and tools at your fingertips that are free, so use them to your advantage. I feel like once you start learning different techniques and what the different machines actually do, then you start getting more motivated. And like I said, there's so many videos on Instagram, YouTube. Check out Whitney Simmons, Nikki Blackheader. I've had a couple questions asking what Alex and Ani bracelets I own. They were all gifts. I have like an Army one, an Auburn one, and then I forget what the last one's called. I forget what the last one's called, but they were all gifts, and I love them. I love wearing them. I get this question a lot. Someone, like my wedding planner, also asked me who the designer was for my dress, my wedding dress. I have no idea. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't know anything about wedding dresses. I didn't know who made them. I didn't know. I mean, I knew Vera Wang. I feel like Vera Wang is something, someone that everyone knows, but my dress is not Vera Wang. But I didn't really pay attention to who it's by. I've had that question quite a few times, and I feel like it's the proper answer to know who your wedding dress is by, but I'm just like, This is a really good question, because I remember this specifically. Anna said, were you nervous to go makeup-free around Davis for the first time? Love you. And when Davis and I first started dating, so we met the first night, and then he left for Europe the next day, left for like, what was it, a month? And basically all our dates like were FaceTime, and I remember specifically the first FaceTime call that he did. First off, I never used FaceTime before meeting Davis ever, and he was like, let's FaceTime, and I was like, what? No. We ended up starting to FaceTime more, but then there was one evening where I didn't have makeup on and my hair wasn't done, and I was like, oh god, I'm so nervous. I hope he watched some of my videos. It was so nerve-wracking, but like once I got on, it was so easy, and I don't even know why I was nervous with him because I felt comfortable about everything else, and like I literally did that for a living. Like I'm on camera without makeup, but I was so nervous. I was so nervous. But I think too, because FaceTime was also new to me, and FaceTime was not a new thing. It was just I never used it. But I was like, I don't know how I feel because I can look at myself and I like the way I look, but you know, now he sees it all the time. What I'm using right now is the new Bite Beauty. This is their liquefied lip and whip. This is so nice. I wore it yesterday and I loved it. So this is the makeup look, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I think it turned out really pretty. I like it a lot. I love a good bronze eye, but I think I love it a little bit more because this shirt, they kind of like just go together. But thank you so much for watching. I really hope you guys enjoyed this. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave, and I will see you all in my next video.